गुड मॉर्निंग, माई सेल्फ डॉली अग्रवाल वेलकम्स यू टू माई चैनल. टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट विद द सेकेंड सेशन ऑफ क्लास 6, चैप्टर 1, प्री हिस्ट्री एंड हिस्ट्री. ऑब्जेक्टिव्स इन टुडेज सेशन वी विल लर्न अबाउट द फॉलोइंग थिंग्स. वॉट आर द सोर्सेज ऑफ प्री हिस्ट्री? वॉट डू वी मीन बाय रिटन रिकॉर्ड्स? What are inscriptions? How do coins and seals tell us about history? What are monuments? How different events are dated in history? In the previous session of chapter 1, prehistory and history, we studied about the sources of prehistory. Now, in our second session, we will learn about sources of history. Now, as you all know that history is studied mainly through written or documented accounts. Written means sources which are available to us in written form or in the form of buildings like manuscripts, inscriptions, coins and monuments. Now, what are written records? Handwritten records are called manuscripts. Handwritten means written by hand. Before the people invented paper, they used to write on dried palm leaves, bark of trees and parchment. Parchment means the dried skin of sheep and goats. Languages used in these manuscripts are not in use now. Classical Greek and Latin language, these were used in Europe, while in India, Pali and Sanskrit were used to write these manuscripts. These manuscripts tell us about the kings and queens, court scenes, battles, experiences of travelers, and many more important events. Written records are of three types: religious, sacred, and accounts of travelers. First, we will discuss about religious writings. Religious writings are those writings which mainly deals with the religion, like examples, the Purans, the Triptakas and the Angas. These books provide information about the social structure, the political system and the religious beliefs of the people of that particular time. Then the second written records are kind of secular writing. Secular means non-religious, means in which nothing is related to religion there. These literature are called secular literature and it includes stories, poems, books on laws and on society. For example, Arthashastra, which was written by Kautilya. Kautilya is the author here and Arthashastra is the book written by him. It tells us about the administration and socio-economic conditions of India during the Mauryan period. Second example of secular writing is Harshcharita, which was written by Banbhat. It also provides information about the administrative structure and the social conditions. Then the third kind of written records are accounts of travelers. Travelers means the people who visited India, means the foreign people who visited India during different periods of history there. In this, three are given here in your book. First is Megasthenes, who visited India. during Chandragupta, and he wrote which book? Indica. Then two Chinese travelers also came to India during that time. And under them comes, first is Faxian, or we can say Fayan, and the second one is Zhuang Zhang or Huan Tishang. They throw light on the reign of the Guptas and the Harshvardhan. Now we move on to the next source of history, that is inscriptions. These are writings written on hard surfaces like stones, rocks, pillars, etc. One of the famous inscriptions is the stone edicts of Ashoka. They tell us about the king, the people and their life. Next source of history are coins and seals. Like the coins that we use today, many ancient coins also had pictures and words on both sides, depicting gods and goddesses, battle scenes, faces of kings and queens, and many more events. The study of coins is called numismatics. Seals also tell us about the past with pictures of animals and inscriptions inscribed on them. Like from Indus Valley seals, we come to know about animals like rhinoceros and deer. Next source of history are monuments. These are ancient buildings that still remain today, like the Taj Mahal, the Sanchi Stupa, and they tell us about the period in which year they were built and who built them. Last topic of your chapter is history and time. In history, recognition of dates is important, of important events is most valuable to us. Certain key terms are used in history to denote the dates there, like decade, which is a period of 10 years, century, which is a period of 100 years, millennium, which is a period of 1000 years. Then, traditionally, the birth of Christ was used as the point from which years were numbered in history. The years before the birth of Christ were labeled as BC, meaning before Christ, and the years after the birth of Christ were labeled AD, or Anno Domini we can say, meaning in the year of our Lord in Latin. These days we use the terms CE and BCE in place of AD and BC. CE stands for Common Era, while BCE stands for Before Common Era. An important thing which we have to keep in mind while writing the dates, that the in the period before the birth of Christ, years are counted backwards, that is the year 200 BCE comes after the year 500 BCE on the timeline. Now in certain dates we can see that CE is written together with the year of that particular event. CE, it is a circa, we can say it is a Latin word that means around or approximately. CE is used when the exact date of an event is not known. Recapitulation. Let us recapitulate what we have learned in today's session in the form of short question answers.